So how are we the secret of spaces? Just see the name. The secret of the spaces lie in ability to involve the basis vectors. The basis vectors, the inventions of the basis vector form the secret of spaces. So if you are able to invent the space, this vector, this basis in such a way that they are ortho normal or orthogonal. If you are able to invent orthonormal basis, then you have demystified the secret of space. If in a function, in the simple xyz, the three-dimensional domain, this x, y, and z are orthonormal basis, and therefore you get this three-dimensional space. In a functional space, the simple function, this discrete function, you are able to get this delta of n minus 1, delta of n minus 2, and all those functions. They are nothing but they cut the function in different parts in such a way that all of them are perpendicular to each other. If you go to the frequency domain, you see that this frequency, this other frequency, this third frequency, they are also orthogonal, this perpendicular to each other. Just two dot product of any one of them will get zero. So the secret of spaces lie in ability to invent basis. And the structure of such basis, the structure must be that every basis, basis 1, basis 2, must be 0 for all these basis, let me tell I comma j, for all I not equal to j, and they must be equal to, this basis must be equal to 1 for I equal to j. If you are able to get such kind of basis for anything, then you have created a new space. You have actually created a new space. This is the summary of every transformation, because the moment you are trying to get such, you get this dot product, this space, then you are able to get a dual Hilbert space, because in this inner product structure, this is the beauty of the spaces. This is the beauty that by just getting this what we call the orthonormal basis, you are able to create a new space out of it. Just see how I am going to do. Just see this delta of n minus 1, delta of n, they are orthonormal. Just see. Because you dot product delta of n with delta of n minus 1, it will give equal to 0. Just see, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. This is 0, 1, and this all 0. If you dot product each one of them, you will get 0. Similarly, you see x dot y is 0, y dot z is equal to 0. And so, what can you see about this space also? These spaces are also orthogonal. If I write sin 3 omega t as some 0, this big vector, infinite dimensional vector. So just tell me, in discrete, it was summation, fn gn, the dot product, okay? So, in continuous, this will be replaced by integration. So if I integrate sin 3 omega t with sin this omega t, the dot product is integration in time, because it is summation in this distance. If I integrate both of them, because this integration is nothing but f of 0, f of tau, f of 3 tau. Just think of ft as a splitted form. Just think of this g of t splitted form. If I multiply these two vectors, then what will I get is that individual products and just summing of all. Or therefore it is called integration. So I just integrate this both, or this integration of sin 3 omega t with omega t, then I will definitely have to get 0. And otherwise, if they are same, then I have to get 1. That's the condition. That's an important condition which we have to satisfy. So, by this, we understand the spaces.